Everybody, I realize like I look terribly haggard right now, but I'm about to put some makeup on. I'll be honest with you, I have been boohooing all morning. It's just been one of those emotional days for me. Day before yesterday, I went out job hunting. Yesterday, I filled out an application that looked very positive. I'm in, just to share my life, I'm in pretty dire straits right now. I've had to borrow a little bit of money. It's going to be okay because I really believe I'm going to get this job. And so I was crying about that, and I realized, you know what, I haven't cried in a really long time, you know, and I think a lot of stuff was coming out. Then the inauguration comes on, right? And it doesn't matter who you voted for, what party you're from. The inauguration is always a very powerful thing. It's so much our country. It's how, just how important. I mean, I think there was like 6 prayers that went out. Billy Graham's son, one of them. I don't know. Just all that stuff gets really emotional for me, you know. And they've, you know, started talking about, you know, one of the pastors, I don't remember which one, started talking about the Beatitudes, and which is, you know, blessed are those that da-da-da because they will da-da-da. Blessed are those that mourn because they will be comforted. That one really got to me. Sorry, you guys. I've been doing this all morning. But no matter who you voted for, or, you know, just, you know, all that kind of goes out the window. I mean, for me, it went out the window just watching the whole thing, you know, watching the process and watching. How am I going to put makeup on when I'm crying? Watching the whole thing, you know, just, for those that chose not to watch it, I totally understand. Kind of. I think it's sad that there was those that chose not even to be there when they had a right to be, when they could have been. Because it was powerful to watch. It was powerful to watch. It was powerful. It was for me. I tend to be a patriotic person. And yes, I used to my fingers still. First thing I'm using is my good old trusty True Match by L'Oreal in the color warm. Light ivory, sorry. Light ivory W2. One thing that was very, very young in hearing, don't ever forget, don't ever neglect your neck. And it's funny because I have never neglected my neck. I've always used a moisturizer. Usually it was, remember the old oil of Olay? I used that. I used to have a feeling like whenever I got out of the shower, don't ever let your face dry out. As soon as I got out, I moisturized my face, and I never forgot my neck. And what's funny is that my neck looks like crap. Yeah, so. Anyways, I was going to go grab my hairband. So hold on a second. coming. Coming, coming, coming. Incoming. Here I am. I'm not going to lie, this lighting makes me look terrible. Boy, there really is something to lighting. Well, next thing I do is I go like this on my hands. Because right here I've got these spots. And to get rid of the rest of the foundation from my hands, I still feel like I have to look good. Even though I don't have any makeup on. Anyways, I get rid of it by doing this. Just because I have marks on my hands. You know, liver spots. Whatever they call them. Next thing I like to do is set things a little bit. A friend actually gave this to me. It's Maybelline's New York. It's this thing. I don't have a lot of great tools as regarding makeup. There's a dot on my screen that's bothering me, but looks like it's going to be there to stay. Sorry, guys. I have to run to the bank, to the store, so I'm just doing a... This is not a tutorial. This is just a whatever I normally do when I go somewhere. I don't usually ever go anywhere without a little bit of makeup on, whether it's just only mascara or something. Just never do. Next thing I do is my eyebrows. The reason why I do my eyebrows next, if I can find my products here, well, just because this stuff has to dry and then I use another product on top of it. This is the Brow Drama. This is in Auburn. And yes, what I do is I go backwards. Why do you go backwards, Jeanette Silhouette? Because I find that that's the best way that coats my lashes, eyebrows. And then I fill in blanks with something else in a minute after this dries. I have found it's best to put this on first rather than the other on first, because this tends to take the other off. So I use this first. Again, the Maybelline Brow Drama. I like to color the lashes kind of by going backwards. Of course, you know, this brow is smaller and lower right there than the other one. But we'll even them out. Don't you worry. We're going to even these suckers out. Lighting sure can make a difference, you guys. You guys, some of this stuff I'm almost embarrassed to show you. I tend to be a very frugal person, and so I've got several blushes. I've showed you guys this before, like a year ago. And just use an old blush brush that I have always found that I really liked. These are old blushes that are crushed up in here that I just shake. And then what's on the lid, I put on my brush, and when that runs out, then I'll be buying a new blush. Until then, I'm going to use up what I have. Kind of what I have to do right now. I feel like I want to put some lips on right now, so I'm going to go ahead and... found this the other day when I was looking for lipsticks. I have no idea what it is. I think it's Clinique something or other. Something from Clinique. Next thing I'm going to do is use a Maybelline New York Brown. I'm just going to go all over my lid. Actually, this is probably not the next thing I would have done. But before I put that all over my lid, I'll do what I normally would have done next, which is, this is a Bebo product. Sorry guys, Bebo is no longer around. From my understanding. And this is something that's not even for this. I don't even know what it's for. I use it on my eyes, though. I would explain more intensely what it is, but again, it's not available anymore. Now I'll do what I meant to do next. And really, what I have to do, I can't do that 7 thing. Or that V thing. I don't put this all over my lid. Let me see what we got going on here. Things look different in my mirror than they look in the camera. I look a lot better in my mirror than I look at my camera right now. But I put it in this section of my eye where you would put the 7. I don't know. 7's in me, as far as makeup goes. I'll show you what I do. Now, this is a little bit darker of a brown. I want it right there. It's kind of like I'm doing a 7. But not really. Brush some of that off and kind of even things out. Take that trusty brush that had some white on it. Oh, great, it's saying low battery. Do you mind holding on while I plug you in? Hold on a second. I sure do wish I knew how to edit, you guys. But hey, maybe some of you are bored and just want to keep me company. That would be nice. I'm going to have to take some kind of video and practice with it as regarding editing goes. Okay. Got it plugged in. Okay, I'm going to be quick now. The next thing is this thing here. This is waterproof eyeliner by, I think it's L'Oreal. I don't know. I've had it for a long time. I've showed it to you guys before. Hope you can see it. Again, this really isn't about... It's kind of about products I'm using, but it's not necessarily about, hey, go buy this because it's great. If I ever say that, you'll know it's good. So, instead of doing the 7, now I'm doing a thick eyeliner here. Then come to a thin. Just works out better for me. Thick eyeliner here. Bring it to a thin. Watch that you don't go into your eyeball. Now, this stuff I have found I don't have a problem with putting it in my waterline. I'm careful. It's practically a dry brush. This stuff is not liquidy. Boy, this is not easy to see. Really can't see that side hardly at all. I am just blindly putting this in. No. Let's do that. Let's do that. No. Good. Hi again. So I'll turn this way, it's more natural light. Kind of. Again, I've been crying though, you know? I mean, feel like I look like crap no matter what I do here. I've got some mascara here that I'm going to use that I bought. Tried this when I was a teenager. Decided to try it again. Was sorry I did. Yeah. Better learn to edit or you guys are gonna hate me. Oh my god. Yeah, the job thing, they said that they would call me, get a hold of me at the beginning of next week, which I'm assuming is like Monday or Tuesday, somewhere around in there. Maybe they're gonna check my references. I have very good references. Now, the last thing, and I'm not sure how long that took. Took a while. If I can find it, I'm going to put a little bit of pink over this. Just a little. is the Define a Brow. Maybelline's. That was probably upside down. Maybelline New York Define a Brow. Now, this color is in light brown. I don't know if they have it in Auburn, but my eyebrows are slightly crunchy right now because I have the other product on, but that's okay. I like a kind of a larger brow. Dear. I just kind of like to make my brows a little bit larger than I guess what they normally are. But that's about it. Now I will show you what I got going on. That out. Anyways, I guess I look better than what I did when I was crying. Anyways, you guys have a good day. I'll check back with you later. I think I'll try. We'll see. All right. Thanks for hanging out with me while I did my makeup and listening to me chat. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.